Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today, I want to show you how the switch function can outperform if statements in Microsoft Excel. If you'd like to follow along with today's lesson, I have the practice sheet down below in the description where you can click on it and download it and work through it as I show you. I'm kind of curious, how many of you have heard of the switch function in Microsoft Excel before, and how many have used it, and what are the results when you're using it? Let me know down below in the comments. So what we're going to do, first of all, is I'm going to show you the if statement that I've already created in this one, and I'm going to create the same type of functionality with the switch statement down below. So if you take a look at the formula bar up here, you can see I have the if statements, it's nested ifs in it. It goes through and finds if this number matches to whatever, it's going to give back the word, like average here. So 3 equals average. In this case, I copied it down. Good is 4, and so on. So it works well, it copies down. But now we're going to create the switch, show you the switch function in here. And I just want to show you why it's a little bit more streamlined and a little bit more efficient to use, especially if you're adding to it. So let's go ahead and start this. Let's go ahead and start the switch function right here in D12. I'm just going to place my equal sign and start typing switch. And I have it right here. So we can take a look at what it does. Evaluates an expression against a list of values and returns the result corresponding to the first matching value. If there's no match, an optional default value is returned. And I'll place that at the end. So let's go ahead and select that switch. And I'm going to start with selecting the cell that I'm going to be looking at. And it's going to be this one right here. So that's my reference. Place my comma in, and all I have to do now is give it the first what it's going to be looking for. So the number one, comma, and if it is number one, what do I want it to be? Well, it's just going to say poor. And then I can just place another comma, put my two, a comma, and then place what's the two going to be equal to. So this is going to be below average, like so. And we can continue on. So let me go ahead and fill this out. And so notice when I got to the end, not rated, there's no number that that's compared to there. So it's just going to be, if it's not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's what's going to have the option. Now, notice when I do this, it just has the one bracket at the end, one bracket at the very beginning, not like the nested if that had to close every one of those opening brackets. So if I was going to make this longer, I can just quickly add another comma in here and continue on with my list. Let's go ahead and hit enter and copy this down, and you're gonna see it gives me the same results. But the advantage of this is going into this and formatting it, if I needed to add more, when I compare it to this, you can see this is a little bit longer and there's just a few more things you have to adjust to make changes to. Let me give you another example now. Before I move over to the example two, I just want to show you that the switch function did work. If it wasn't listed, it took the alternative, not rated there. Now at the bottom, move over to example two, and we're going to do a operation, so multiplication using the switch function. So I'm going to have this right here. So here's total sales, and we have regions. But the commission is different for each region. So I'm going to be multiplying this by a certain number based on it switching to north, south, east, west, central, or other. Now I'm going to place my switch function in here. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. But the first thing I'm going to do is just select this cell and start my multiplication. So this is going to be multiplied. And now I can start my switch here. And I'm going to choose this and start filling it out. So it's going to be based on D2 because it's going to look up what region it is. And then, so what I put my comma in, and then it's going to be saying north. Make sure that we have everything spelled exactly the same. And north is going to be a certain commission. So I'm going to say it's going to be 0.05. And then we can place our comma and then go ahead and type our next one, like so. So we're going to keep filling this out just like we did before. So I'm going to go quickly finish this up. So now I have it all finished up. I closed it up. I have north, south, east, west with the different commission rates for each of them. Notice that I don't have central in there because it's going to be the other one, the only other option. And I'm just going to put zero there. So that's what it should give back. So let's hit enter and copy this down. And so central shouldn't be anything if I copy that down. And you can see that it is at zero. So at each of these, as I copied it down, it went through, it switched it to which one I needed. So this one went over to the south, took the 0.6, multiplied it by the 15,000, and we got it there. So again, another efficient way to use this switch function in Microsoft Excel. Let's move over to another example for the last one. So in this example, I started with an if statement, and then I'm going to put a nested switch inside of it. Let me explain what I want to have happen here. So we're going to look at this column right here, look at difficulty level, and it needs to assign a number to medium, easy, hard, different numbers. And then it needs to look at urgency and assign a number to high, low, medium. And it needs to add these two together to get a final number. But at the same time, if any of these are blank, I need it to just return a priority score of zero. So I'm going to click in where my formula is and take a look at it. So you can see I started with an if here, and then I had an or statement, and I used the function is blank. So it took a look at C2 and said, if this is blank, then it needs to return a zero. And I'll show you that that will work. But it also needs to look at D2 and do the same thing, return zero. Now, this is where the switch comes in. So a switch, it's going to take a look at C2, and we're going to just before, like before, assign those numbers to what it says. So you can see easy is 1, medium is 2, and hard is 3. I've added an operation. I need to add the 2, so I'm adding another switch to do this column right here. And doing the same, low 0, medium 1, and so on. So those two are going to get added, and I have my close brackets at the end of just the two brackets. So when this is all said and done, I can copy this down and it works for each of them. And like I said, if one of these are blank, if I go ahead and delete it, it will turn the priority score to a zero using the function. So this is where it's coming in at the beginning with the if or is blank, and here's the zero returns. So I hope you like these different ways to use this switch function in Microsoft Excel. It can be a lot more efficient than just using the if statement and using nested ifs. Give it a try. Let me know what you think if this comes in handy for you. Thanks for watching this time on Teacher's Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.